Well, obviously, there is some limit to what we can borrow. We're not at it now. And the president is determined to spend what we need to spend. The $3 trillion we spent plus $1 trillion more, that's about 20% of GDP. I mean, that's just absolutely historic. And we're prepared to put more money on the table. So there are things, as I said, that made sense to compromise, we've compromised. So we're not stuck at the $1 trillion, but we're not going to go to unlimited amounts of money to do things that don't make sense.
But it's not unlimited. I mean, I think that's hyperbole, Mr. Secretary. About $3 trillion, $1 trillion, you split it. You go to $2 trillion, or maybe you go to $1.8 trillion. But certainly, if this is a war, we can't split hairs. It's unfortunate.
Jim, we're splitting things that make sense to split. So let me be clear. You know, if I had started at zero and they had started at $10 trillion, would that have made sense to do a $5 trillion deal? Of course not. So you don't just split the difference. What you do is you go line by line. You say, let's agree where we can agree. And you're right. On things where we agree but we're apart on money, we split the difference. Things like food, I listened to the speaker over the weekend. She's right. We started low on food. We realize there's a lot of kids out there that there's an issue. So we agreed on more than enough money for this year and through most of next year on food. We didn't make long-term policy changes in the middle of COVID. So we did that. And we can go down the list, and that's what we've done. But what we're not going to do is say where there's really bad policy ideas, we're not going to just split the difference.
When are you guys planning on getting back together to talk? Do you have any idea?
Again, I'm not going to comment on the specifics of the logistics of negotiations because I don't think that that's helpful. You know, there's a deal to do if the Democrats are reasonable and want to compromise. And if their attitude is, you know, we'd rather give you nothing than agree on things, then we're not going to get a deal. But I heard Pelosi over the weekend and Schumer, and I think they're willing to compromise. So, again, if we can get a fair deal, we'll do it this week. But the president needed to take action. He's not going to sit around. We left the meeting on Friday. Mark Meadows and I reported back to him that we were nowhere, and that's why he moved forward.